come on, man. And with the local DBC news, LL Cool J with a triumphant comeback.
More so than before, but tonight.
Don't call it a comeback. I've been here for years. I'm rocking my pants, putting suckers in fear. Making the tears rain down like a monsoon. Listen to the bass go boom. I'm gonna knock you out. Mama said knock you out. I'm gonna knock you out. Mama said knock you out.
What is good, YouTube? It is me, Wayne, the Average Gamer, and I'm back in a building. I'm so shocked. I'm so surprised that I'm actually here talking to you today. Because I've been so busy, and a good busy. I've been busy with the family. I've been busy outdoors. I've been busy with vacation. I've been busy with so many other things besides gaming. Therefore, I hadn't posted any gameplays, but I have gameplays galore, and I have them, and I'm like, why am I continuously doing this when I really don't have the time to upload? But today, my friends, today, I decided to bless you with my presence on YouTube and talk about this beta. I had so much fun over the weekend actually getting to learn this game, experiment in this game, and understand this game's meta. Now, you've probably heard all your favorite YouTubers out there talk about this game. Some have been paid to talk about it in a positive way, some have not. Many have talked about it in a negative way. But has anybody, do you think anyone has told you truthfully what they feel about the game? And I say, yes, there's a couple of people out there that do. And I'm going to tell you the truth and how I feel about the game. I mean, the beta, really. And it's just the beta. There's things that have to be fixed. And I'm pretty sure you heard about it. I'm pretty sure you heard about the underwhelming score streaks. But I just want to say this. The way the map's layouts are, there's cover everywhere. I don't fear any score streak except those that are mobile, like the RCXD. That thing will come up behind you and blow you to bits. But the sentry guns and all the aerial strikes, I mean, I got cold-blooded on. They got cold-blooded ready for me. They got ghosts ready for me. They got all these other perks ready for me. Why should I fear any of the score streaks, even if they buff them? You can't see me on the screen. It's a hunt and peck trying to use them. So they'll never be overwhelming unless they get rid of some of these crutch perks. The crutch perk that I use the most, I use Engineer so I can see all the peripherals, because everybody in this game is putting stuff down, landmines, anything and everything that can blow you up, deter you, and slow you down from getting to your objective. And the objective at the end of the day for me, whether you play TDM or whatever it is to kill other players. Now, the gunplay in the game is ridiculous. Oh, but let me go back to the crutch perks I use. I use Engineer, I use Dead Silence, I use Ghost, and I use Cold Blooded. I don't use Gung Ho, I don't use Lightweight, I don't use any of those. I need to know where you are. I need to be able to move to where I need to as silently as I can. And then I use acoustics so I can see where the heck you are, north, south, east, or west of me. So I use those crutch perks to navigate the map. When I first started the game, I didn't know where anybody was. I actually started camping it up or strategically positioning myself so I could be less of an objective for people to kill. But now that I've kind of used these crutch perks, and the only deterrence is everybody run the same thing. And if everybody's running the same thing, then the game becomes back an even playing field. But I know people aren't going to do that. But let's talk about the weapons. When I used the ICR, I think that's what it's called, one of the first tier assault rifle weapons, I was doing great from a distance. But if I got close up to a person with an SMG, I was getting melted. So you have to play to the weapon's strength. And if you don't, you're going to be done. Also, this game is Call of Duty at its core, but it doesn't play like any other Call of Duty game. It's so different, but yet it's familiar. Because if Call of Duty is the only game that you ever play and experience, then you will feel like it's probably the worst game you've ever played because it doesn't feel exactly like the core Call of Duty style of game. So if you played Overwatch, if you played Rainbow Six Siege, if you played a couple of other different games, then now this game starts to feel more familiar and you start to understand the mechanics of the game. And once you realize that, then the aha moment happens. Then the game doesn't suck, right? Because my initial reactions was the game was just okay. It was decent. But then after I started thinking and I watched the other couple of other people, YouTubers, post their comments, and I started reevaluating what I really thought and how I felt as I was playing, the game's not bad. But after 2 months, like every other Call of Duty game, everybody's going to complain. That's just a simple fact. And I'm not going to make this commentary longer than it needs to be. Maybe I need to make another one. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to end this commentary and I'll probably come back to make another one and let you guys know some other stuff. This is me, your boy Wayne, the Average Gamer, telling you the truth about what I feel about this beta. I'm going to buy the game. I'm going to play the game and I'm going to have fun in the game. No matter what anybody else says, because that's my opinion.